Hi students, in this video let us discuss about multiple and submultiple angles, which is part of trigonometry chapter. So what is basically a multiple and submultiple angle? So for example, if you take an angle A, let us suppose A is an angle, then any integral multiple of A will be called as a multiple angle of A. Any integral multiple of A, that means 2A, some integer into A, 3A, 4A, and so on, some integer into A. All these angles are called as multiple angles of A. And when we consider A multiplied with a fraction, or multiples of A with a fraction, is said to be a submultiple angle of A. So multiply A with a fraction, that means A into 1 by 2, A into 1 by 3, A multiplied with 3 by 2, A multiplied with 2 by 3. So any fraction multiplied with A will be called as a submultiple angle of A. Any integer multiplied with A will be called as a multiple angle of A. So these are the examples for multiple angles and submultiple angles of A when A is some angle basically. Now let us try to derive some formulas for multiple and submultiple angles. So first, let us try to derive the formulas of trigonometric ratios for 2A. Now 2A is a multiple angle anyhow. So to get the formulas for trigonometric ratios of 2A, I have taken compound angle formulas of A plus B here. So in this first formula, if B is replaced with A, what you will get? If B is replaced with A, sine of A plus A means sine 2A, sine A into cos A, because B is replaced with A, sine A into cos A plus cos A into sine A. Now sine A cos A, this is also sine A cos A. So sine of A plus A means sine 2A is equal to sine A cos A plus sine A cos A, means 2 sine A cos A we will get. Just in this formula, replace B with A. So if we replace B with A, then we will get sine 2A is equal to 2 sine A cos A. So this is basically the formula of sine 2A. Sine 2A, 2A means multiple angle only, no? So therefore, this is multiple angle formula of 2A. Next, in this formula, replace B with A. So cos of A plus A is equal to cos A minus sin A into sin A. So if B is replaced with A, you will get cos 2A is equal to cos A, that means cos square A minus sin A into sin A, sin square A. So this is the basic formula for cos 2A, cos square A minus sin square A. Now if you want to write the formula completely in terms of cos, write sin square A as 1 minus cos square A. If you want to get the formula completely in terms of sin, write cos square A as 1 minus sin square A. So both I will show you. So if you write cos square A as 1 minus sin square A, 1 minus sin square A minus sin square A, that means 1 minus 2 sin square A. This is formula in terms of sin. Okay. So if you write 1 minus cos square A here, if sin square A is written as 1 minus cos square A, you will get the formula as 2 cos square A minus 1. All these are cos 2A formulas only. So this is the general formula. This is same formula in terms of sin, same formula in terms of cos. All these are cos 2A formulas. Now coming to this one, In this formula, if you replace B with A, tan of A plus A is equal to tan A plus tan A by 1 minus tan A into tan A. So what we are going to get, if you replace B with A, tan of A plus A, that means tan 2A, is equal to tan A plus tan A, that means 2 tan A, by 1 minus tan A into tan A, 1 minus tan square A. So this is the basic formula of tan 2A. Now come to this one, replace B with A here, then cot of A plus A means 2A is equal to cot A into cot A, that means cot square A minus 1 by cot A plus cot A, 2 cot A. So this is the formula of cot 2A. So we have written trigonometric ratios for 2A. So therefore these are multiple angle formulas. So if you want secant 2A, just write 1 by cos 2A and use this formula. If you want cosecant 2A, write 1 by sin 2A and use this formula. Now the same formulas, if you want to represent in terms of submultiple angles, if you want the formulas in terms of submultiple angles, just replace A with A by 2 in these formulas. Just replace A with A by 2, that's all. Just observe here, if you write A by 2 in place of A, sine of 2 into A by 2, that means we will get sine A is equal to 2 sine A by 2 cos A by 2. Both formulas are same only, but this formula is in terms of A by 2. In terms of A by 2, A by 2 is a submultiple angle, no? So the same formula in terms of A by 2 means submultiple formula this is. Just if you replace A with A by 2, you get like this. Similarly, in this formula, if you replace A with A by 2, what you will get? Cos A is equal to cos square A by 2 minus sin square A by 2. So this is submultiple formula because the formula is in terms of A by 2. So come to here, replace A with A by 2. What you will get? Tan A is equal to 2 tan A by 2. So this is tan of A by 2. You can't cancel this 2 with this 2. Okay. Tan of some angle, this one. Okay. So 2 tan A by 2 by 1 minus tan square A by 2. So this is the formula of tan 2A in terms of tan A. When you replace A with A by 2 here, so this is what we get. Formula is in terms of A by 2, therefore this is submultiple formula. The same we can actually write for cot 2A also. So these are the formulas of trigonometric ratios corresponding to 2A and the corresponding submultiple formulas also we have written. Now let us go to trigonometric ratios corresponding to 3A. So for example, if you want cos 3A formula, you write that as cos of 2A plus A. Why we are writing like this? So if you write cos of 2A plus A, this is cos of A plus B model. So this is cos of A plus B model. So use cos of A plus B formula. So we can write cos 2A into cos A minus sin 2A into sin A. Now cos 2A formula, just now we have derived. Cos 2A formula in terms of cos I will write. So in terms of cos, 2 cos square A minus 1. Cos 2A formula into cos A, and what is sin 2A formula? 2 sin A cos A into sin A. Okay, so now cos A multiplied with this. So cos A multiplied with first term 2 cos cube A you will get. Cos A multiplied with minus 1. Now here 2 cos A sin a into sin a, you will get sin square a. Now, if I want the formula completely in terms of cos, I can change sin square a as 1 minus cos square a. So, if I use 1 minus cos square a here, the complete term will be in terms of cos function. Okay. So, 2 cos cube a minus cos a minus 2 cos a into, in place of sin square a, write 1 minus cos square a. Now simplify. So 2 cos cube a minus cos a minus 2 cos a into 1 and minus 2 cos a into minus cos square a. So plus 2 cos cube a. So 2 cos cube a plus 2 cos cube a, I can write as 4 cos cube a. Minus cos a minus 2 cos a means minus 3 cos a. So this is the formula of cos 3a basically. So if you want to derive sin 3a, same process you will do. Sin 3a means sin of 2a plus a we will write. Use compound angle formula, simplify. So all the formulas or all the trigonometric ratios for 3a you can derive in the same process. Okay. So, if you derive the formula of sin 3a, so we will get in the same process sin 3a as 3 sin a minus 4 sin cube a. So, if you derive for tan 3a, we will get in the same process 3 tan a minus tan cube a by 1 minus 3 tan square a. So, this is the formula of tan 3a. And cot 3a formula is also same as tan 3a. Just replace tan with cot, that's all. Cot 3a formula is same as this one. Just replace tan with cot, that will be cot 3a formula. Now these are the formulas of cos 3a, sin 3a, tan 3a. 3a is there, no? So multiple angle formulas. So if you want the same formulas written in submultiple angles, just replace a with a by 3. Why we are replacing with a by 3? If a is replaced with a by 3, here you will get cos a, sin a, tan a like that. In the RHS, you will find submultiple angles. Okay, so replace a with a by 3. I'll write here. Replacing a with a by 3 in all the formulas. So in place of a, write a by 3. Cos of 3 into a by 3, that means cos a. So cos a is equal to, this is the formula, no? So 4 cos cube a by 3 minus 3 cos a by 3, you will get like this. Okay, replace a with a by 3. So we will get sin a is equal to 3 sin a by 3 minus 4 cos cube, sorry, sin cube a by 3. Now here replace a with a by 3, what you will get? Tan a is equal to 3 tan a by 3 minus tan cube a by 3 by 1 minus 3 tan square a by 3. So these are submultiple formulas, same formulas, but they are submultiple formulas because we are expressing in terms of a by 3, which is actually a multiple of 1 by 3. Okay. So this completes the discussion of trigonometric ratios for 3a. Okay. Now let us go to the next model of formulas. So next model, so we know that cos 2a is equal to 2 cos square a minus 1, already we just derived. So using this formula, we can write 1 plus cos 2a is equal to 2 cos square a. So if you divide by 2, what you will get? cos square a is equal to 1 plus cos 2a by 2. So these are the conditions which we have to remember. 1 plus cos 2a is 2 cos square a, or cos square a is 1 plus cos 2a by 2. So if you take square root on both sides, cos a is plus or minus under root 1 plus cos 2a by 2. So this is cos a in terms of cos 2a. So this is multiple angle formula, because the formula is in terms of 2a. So if you want submultiple formula, replace a with a by 2. So if you replace a with a by 2, cos a by 2 will be plus or minus under root 1 plus cos a by 2. This is submultiple formula. Same formula, when we replace a with a by 2, we will get like this. So this is the formula of cos a in terms of cos 2a. Similarly, we can derive for sin a also. So just take this formula. Cos 2a, we can write as 1 minus 2 sin square a also. So from this formula, you can write 2 sin square a is equal to 1 minus cos 2a. This we have to remember. 1 minus cos 2a is 2 sin square a. We have to remember that. Okay, so from this formula, we will get sin a is equal to 1 minus cos 2a by 2. Sorry, sin square a. So therefore, sin a becomes plus or minus under root 1 minus cos 2a by 2. This is sin a formula in terms of cos 2a. Okay. Now, if you want the formula in terms of a by 2, because this is submultiple formula, we have 2a here. So, if you want the formula, this is multiple angle formula, sorry. If you want the submultiple formula, replace a with a by 2. So, replace a with a by 2, what we will get? Sin a by 2 is equal to plus or minus under root 1 minus cos a by 2. This is submultiple formula. Okay, now how you will decide this plus or minus? When sin a by 2 is positive, we take plus here. When sin a by 2 is negative, we take minus. So how you will know sin a by 2 is positive or negative? Based on the quadrant of a by 2. Based on a by 2 quadrant, we will know whether this sin a by 2 is positive or negative. Based on that, we will take plus or minus sign. The same happens here. So, if cos a by 2 is positive, take plus sign. If cos a by 2 is minus, take negative sign. Now, if you divide these two. Okay. So, if you divide sin a by 2 by cos a by 2. What is that? Tan a by 2. So, if you divide these two. This by this, what you will get? Plus or minus under root 1 minus cos a by 1 plus cos a. So this is the formula of tan a by 2 in terms of cos a. So if you divide these two, sin a by cos a tan a will be plus or minus 1 minus cos 2a by 1 plus cos 2a in square root. So this is basically submultiple formula. So if you want multiple angle formula, you will get like this. So this comes just by dividing sin a cos a. By dividing these two, you will get that automatically. So this is the multiple angle formula. Same formula, but multiple angle formula. So if you reciprocate this, you will get tan cot a. If you reciprocate this, cot a formula. Okay, just reciprocal of this. So cot a also you can write from this. So this completes the discussion of the formulas of cos a and sin a in terms of cos 2a. Now let us have the discussion of sin 2a formula in terms of tan. So this is basically sin 2a formula. So if you want to get the formula in terms of tan, simple. To get tan, divide by cos a, multiply with cos A. Why we will divide and multiply with cos A? Because to get tan, sine must be divided by cos definitely. So what happens here? Sin A by cos A becomes tan A, and cos A into cos A means cos square A. So I want the formula completely in terms of tan. So this cos square A we can write as 1 by secant square A, because secant is reciprocal of cos. Next, 2 tan A by, now secant square A can be written as 1 plus tan square A. This is identity, that's it. So this is formula of sin 2A in terms of tan. Now if you want the formula in terms of A by 2, replace A with A by 2, you will get submultiple formula correspondingly. Okay, so this completes the discussion of sin 2A in terms of tan. Next, now if you want cos 2A formula in terms of tan, cos 2A, basically cos 2A means cos square A minus sin square A. So if you want the formula in terms of tan, wherever you find sin, divide by cos, then only you will get tan. So therefore let us consider dividing by cos square A, because sin by cos only gives us tan. Dividing by cos square A and multiplying with cos square A. Now let us do the division term by term here. Cos square A by cos square A becomes 1. Okay. Minus sin square A by cos square A becomes tan square A. Okay. Cos square A by cos square A. Sin square A by cos square A. Now this cos square A I will write as 1 by secant square A, because I want the complete formula in terms of tan. I am changing cos as 1 by secant. Next, 1 minus tan square A. Now secant square A can be written as 1 plus tan square A. So this is the formula of cos 2A in terms of tan. So if you want the formula in terms of submultiple angles, replace A with A by 2. So if you replace A with A by 2, what we will get? Cos A is equal to 1 minus tan square A by 2 by 1 plus tan square A by 2. So this is submultiple formula. Okay. So cos 2A, cos A, multiple and submultiple formulas in terms of tan. Okay, so I'll come up with more formulas discussion in the next video. Thank you.